Hello, welcome everyone. We're going to give a moment to allow for attendees to join. This is Natalia Jaramillo from the New Florida Majority. Okay, we're giving a minute for everyone to join. Okay, well, good morning. Welcome everyone. I am Natalia Jaramillo, Deputy Communications Director with the New Florida Majority. Buenos días, soy Natalia Jaramillo de la Nueva Mayoría de la Florida. We are starting our press conference today because on Monday, July 20th, is the last day for any Floridian to register to vote if they want to participate in the primaries on August 18th. And as organizations and community leaders in the Latinx community in Florida throughout the state, we are definitely calling out to all our community members to register to vote. And we want the support of the media to help us send this message out. There is approximately 3.1 million Floridians registered, 1.1 million Latinos that are eligible to vote in Florida. It is very interesting, and I was just sharing with the panelists that we went down a rabbit hole yesterday trying to find the official numbers of Latinos that are actually registered in the state of Florida, and that information is not available publicly. The state just doesn't estimate how many Latinos are actually registered. They don't break down, and they don't release information broken down by race or ethnicity. So we know that each party and other organizations make their own estimates, but there's no official data. And that is really significant and very telling in the state that is the third largest state with a Latino electorate in the country. I know we have been doing some digging, and maybe some of our panelists will be able to share the information that they have about how many Latinos are actually registered, but it's important to note that that information is not available publicly. Voy a compartir en español. I'm going to share in Spanish for those that speak Spanish. Bienvenidos a esta conferencia de prensa. Estamos realizando esta llamada hoy porque el lunes 20 de julio es el día final para que la gente de la Florida se pueda inscribir a votar. Y queremos hacer una invitación muy grande para que nuestra comunidad latina se inscriba a votar. Hay aproximadamente 3.1 millones de latinos en la Florida que están elegibles para votar. Desafortunadamente, el estado no tiene información pública sobre cuántos de esos latinos están realmente registrados. Es algo que nos parece importante e interesante que en el estado que tiene el tercer número de votantes latinos más grandes de todo el país, no sepamos cuántos están realmente registrados. Sabemos que los partidos y organizaciones tienen sus datos, sus propios estimados, pero no es información que es pública. Entonces, creemos que eso es algo bien importante para poder movilizar a nuestra comunidad. We're going to start the press conference welcoming Andrea Mercado, Executive Director from the New Florida Majority. Vamos a recibir a Andrea Mercado, la directora ejecutiva de la Nueva Mayoría de la Florida.
Good morning. Buenos días. Monday, July 20th is the last day to register to vote for the Florida primaries. Florida is the state with the third largest Latino electorate in the country. And this Monday is our last chance to register to vote or change party affiliation to be able to participate in these primary elections on August 18th. If you're not registered to vote in Florida or you're not registered with the political party, you won't be able to vote in many critical elections in Florida. Everything from sheriff's races to state attorneys to mayors and who's going to represent us in the state legislature. Time and time again, we've seen that it's not only the president or members of Congress in Washington, D.C. who make important decisions that affect our lives. And right now, you know, the Latino community is experiencing unprecedented hardship. Latino and Black community members are three times more likely to contract COVID, than their white counterparts, they're two times more likely to die from this disease. And in this moment, we're experiencing, you know, Latinos have been in the crosshairs of the Trump administration since he took office. And the Latino community is not a sleeping giant. Latino voters are wide awake and they will turn out to vote if candidates and organizations engage with our community. But it's really important that Latinos understand that Monday, July 20th is the deadline. And, you know, that's how we're gonna be able to elect people who will really go to bat for our communities. This 2020 election will be the most consequential election in our modern history. And these August elections are critical for determining so many down ballot races that impact our day-to-day lives, our schools, our economy, who represents us in Tallahassee, and to, you know, break the right-wing stranglehold in Tallahassee. You know, we know that, you know, even though Latinos represent such a large part of the electorate here in Florida, demography is not destiny, and we need to energize this electorate. We need to realize our power as a voting bloc, and we need to make sure that Latinos are registering to vote by this deadline on July 20th to make sure that we're electing the best candidates for the seats that decide whether or not to open the schools or not during a pandemic, to protect undocumented immigrants and, you know, workers that are being laid off in record numbers, or to turn our local police into immigration officers. So I'm so happy to be a part of this movement to energize our electorate, and our we're part of a massive effort called Florida for All. It's the largest Black and brown led independent expenditure in the state. We're aiming to talk to over 3 million Floridians in 19 counties in advance of the August and November elections. And it's really an effort that's led by Latino and African American led organizations. And for us to really claim our power and transform the state. So with that, I'll turn it back over to Natalia and the incredible leaders that we have with us on this call today.
Thank you so much, Andrea. Now we're gonna hear from Rubén Lebrón, political director from Alianza por Progres. Ahora vamos a escuchar a Rubén Lebrón de Alianza por el Progreso.
Good morning, everyone. Like she said, my name is Ruben Lebrón, and I'm the political director for Alianza for Progress. Muy buenas tardes a todos. Gracias por estar aquí esta mañana. And Alianza for Progress is here this morning because Florida is home to 1.4 million Puerto Ricans. Many of them folks who just recently came from the island because of the many things that are happening there, from natural disasters to political instability. A lot of them don't know that they can actually vote on these elections, and they're not familiar with like Florida politics. And that's what Alianza focuses on. You know, we want to provide education, excitement, and engagement around voting and politics to this key demographic in this very crucial year of 2020. So a lot of the work that we've been doing is primary voter education. What seats are up for grabs, what those elected offices do, and how they can improve our day-to-day lives. We've actually hosted 8 out of a total of 12 candidate forums that you can find in our Facebook page, Alianza for Progress, that have been very popular with our community, and where candidates have made the case as to why they're the best representatives for the Latino community, especially for races and contested races that are in highly dense Latino districts. Additionally, through our field program in our communications department, we've been stressing the importance of voting in these primaries. We have to make sure that people realize that our local elections can sometimes have the biggest impact on our day-to-day lives, on things like whether their schools open or close, how our tax dollars are spent, criminal justice reform in this era of of police brutality in all the protests that are happening as a result of the death and killing and murder of George Floyd. So this primary election is our chance, you know, to make big changes at the local level, from reproductive rights to healthcare system and an affordable housing for all. And the only way we can achieve that is through the vote. We've been also running a rigorous vote by mail campaign, and we're really advertising it as a safe and effective way to participate in these elections. So people don't have to choose between their right to vote and the safety of their family. And also dispelling a lot of the myths that the GOP has been spreading in hopes of lowering voter turnout around the state. The last thing voters want to hear during this pandemic is that voting by mail is not secure. People want peace of mind that they can exercise their right to vote from the safety of their homes. But even though we haven't been able to knock doors this cycle, we've been focusing on our digital program, from digital door knocking to phone banking and texting, to make sure that we are engaging people and turning them out. We've actually registered just in the last 3 weeks more than 1,000 people to sign up to vote by mail. And we've made about 20,000 phone calls and 100,000 text messages to people in three key counties, in Osceola, in Hillsborough, and in Orange County. We currently have about 2.2 million registered voters that identify as Hispanic in the state of Florida. This information is in the voter rolls. And some of our models estimate that from those 2.2 million, between 400,000 and 500,000 of them are Puerto Ricans registered to vote. So we have a lot of work to do. And that's why we're here today. July 20th is the deadline for us to participate and get our last chance to update our voter registrations. So the work is not finished after this, though. Registration is only the first step, and then we have to do our work to get out the vote, elect champions of our community, and that's exactly what we are here to do.
Gracias, Rubén. ¿Quieres compartir un mensaje en español?
Sí, definitivamente. Muy buenas tardes a todos. Mi nombre es Rubén Lebrón y soy el director político de Alianza para el Progreso. Y hoy estamos aquí porque cerca de 1.4 millones de puertorriqueños viven en el estado de Florida. Muchos de ellos han venido recientemente de la isla a causa de huracanes y otras situaciones preocupantes pasando en la isla. Y muchos de ellos no conocen que pueden participar, que pueden votar en el estado de Florida. De hecho, conozco personas, compañeros que trabajan conmigo que pensaban de esta manera, ya que en la isla muchos de nosotros no podemos votar por el presidente si vivimos en Puerto Rico, pero cuando venimos acá y tenemos una dirección aquí, lo podemos hacer. Y eso causa mucha confusión con nuestra comunidad. Entonces, hemos estado haciendo mucha educación para los votantes. Alrededor de las primarias. De hecho, hemos tenido 8 foros de un total de 12 para candidatos en carreras locales, en distritos y condados con una población con una densidad grande de la comunidad latina. Y hablándoles de qué hacen estas posiciones, cómo pueden mejorar su vida y todos esos detalles importantes. Estos foros los pueden ver en nuestra página de Facebook, Alianza for Progress. Y también hemos hecho campañas digitales, campañas de campo, campañas de comunicaciones, para hablarle de los votantes cómo estas carreras locales y estatales a veces son las más importantes de nuestra vida. Impactan cosas como si las escuelas van a abrir o cerrar, cómo se utiliza nuestro dinero como taxpayers, reforma al sistema de justicia criminal. Todas esas cosas son sumamente importantes y queremos asegurarnos de que los votantes estén conscientes de todo eso. Otra cosa que hemos estado haciendo es asegurarnos de que registremos a las personas para votar por correo, ya que esta es la forma más segura y más efectiva para hacerlo en estas elecciones. Las familias no tienen que escoger entre su derecho al voto y la seguridad y salud de toda su familia. Y también hemos tenido que hacer mucha educación con esto, porque hay muchos mitos, especialmente por el partido republicano, que quiere asegurarse de que muchas de nuestras comunidades no salgan a votar. Entonces, lo último que nuestras familias quieren es preocuparse que votar por correo no sea seguro, que vayan a perder su voto, que su voto no sea contado. Aunque no hemos podido ir puerta a puerta para hablar con los votantes sobre esto, sí hemos corrido un programa riguroso de campo en digital, de forma digital y de comunicaciones. Entonces, de hecho, las últimas 3 semanas hemos registrado a más de 1,000 personas a votar por correo. Hemos hecho alrededor de 20,000 llamadas, especialmente en los condados de Orange, Osceola y Hillsborough. Y también hemos enviado más de 100,000 mensajes de texto. En el estado de Florida, actualmente hay alrededor de 2.2 millones de votantes hispanos, que se identifican como hispanos, registrados. Y acerca de eso, nuestros modelos indican que 400,000 a 5,000 son puertorriqueños. Como les dijimos, esta conferencia de prensa es porque nos quedan 4 días para que nuestras comunidades se registren a votar, y por eso es que estamos aquí. Pero la registración a votar no es lo único que vamos a hacer. Después de esto, tenemos que asegurarnos de que elijamos campeones para nuestra comunidad y que saquemos a las personas a votar. Muchas gracias.
Gracias, Rubén. That's very important to hear. According to ANESA for Progress estimates, there's out of the 3.1 million Latinos that are eligible to vote, around 2.2 million are registered. That would leave us with approximately 800,000, 900,000 Latinos that are not registered to vote. Andrea, you wanted to?
I think that my understanding for the state of Florida is that there's 4 million people of color and young people who are eligible to vote and not registered, or registered to vote and not voting. We certainly have a lot of work to do to expand the electorate, and people, you know, we want people to know that to vote in the August elections, the deadline is Monday. But I want to definitely turn it over to my sisters on the call to share their points of view.
Thank you. Now the next speaker that we have is Laura. Laura Munoz from Flick Votes. They're doing really important work as the Florida Immigrant Coalition and the Flick Votes to not only register voters, but also make sure that we expand the electorate, but helping those who are eligible to naturalize to do so. Laura was expecting to be a first-time voter this year, but she's still in the process of naturalization, breaking some myths about how easy it is to naturalize. So she can share her story now. Welcome, Laura.
Thank you so much. Good morning. As mentioned, my name is Laura Munoz, and I am the hotline and citizenship manager with Flick Votes. And yes, I am here to speak about the significance and the power of that first-time voter and that first-time vote. Like many of the people that I work with every single day, my family came to this country when I was just a child seeking safety and opportunity. I grew up to make this country my home. And after all these years, I was really expecting and excited to potentially cast my very first vote this year in this important electoral cycle. But unfortunately, my naturalization journey has not been completed in time for the upcoming voter registration this Monday. So I'm here not only representing, but working and fighting alongside all those aspiring new voters, all those people who call this country their home, but are not yet part of its democracy, all those people who could not complete or could not afford their citizenship process and application, or all those whose vote has yet to be reinstated. We see you, And that's why, while many people in the citizenship pipeline unable to take their oath or attend their interviews will not be able to cast that vote this year, there are thousands of Latinx voters and Floridians here in our states that have naturalized or that have turned 16 since 2016, that have turned 18 since 2016. So I am here speaking to you. As an aspiring first-time voter, I invite you, all those new American voters, to take and own all that power and that voice that that vote gives you. In my role in the naturalization program and with the hotline, talking every single day to voters, talking every single day to people who want to become citizens and immigrants, I understand the urgency, and I know we all do in this particular moment amidst a global pandemic, for bold, compassionate leadership that works for us all, not just the few. So for all those new American voters that might have your doubts about this process, we invite you to visit Flick That Vote today and take your power. Take your power, take a hold of it, and register to vote today. And I'm now gonna speak in Spanish. Buenos días. Mi nombre es Laura Muñoz y soy la directora de la línea directa de apoyo al inmigrante y ciudadanía de Flick Vote. Estoy aquí para hablar sobre el significado y el poder que existe en ese votante que está votando por primera vez. Como muchas de las personas con las que yo trabajo, mi familia vino a este país cuando yo era todavía una niña en busca de seguridad y oportunidades. Crecí para hacer este país mi hogar y después de todos estos años estaba muy ansiosa por emitir mi primera boleta electoral en este año tan importante. Pero desafortunadamente mi proceso de naturalización no se ha completado a tiempo para la próxima fecha límite, este lunes, de registro de votantes. Entonces aquí estoy, no solamente representando, sino trabajando juntos para que todos estos votantes que están aspirando a votar por la primera vez, todas esas personas que llaman a este país su hogar, pero no son parte todavía de su democracia, todos aquellos que no pudieron completar o pagar su proceso de ciudadanía, que todavía no tienen la edad o que no han podido tener su voto restablecido, los vemos y por eso estoy aquí hablándole a aquellos que sí han podido completar esos procesos y que ya son votantes. Para todos esos que ya tienen 18 años o que en esto desde el 2006 han podido completar su proceso de ciudadanía y esa va a ser la primera elección en la que pueden votar. En ese momento y en mi papel como directora del programa de naturalización de ciudadanía y trabajando con la comunidad inmigrante, yo conozco la urgencia, como todos sabemos en esta pandemia, del voto y de tener un liderazgo que nos represente a todos, no solamente a algunos en este momento. Por eso les invitamos a todas esas personas que van a votar por la primera vez que vayan a flick.vote. Y se registren y tomen ese poder que ya tienen después de todos estos años o que ya tienen por primera vez. Tomen ese poder y se registren para votar. Muchísimas gracias.
Gracias, Laura. Thank you so much. Now we're going to hear from María Reveles from Vamos por Puerto Rico and SDIU 32BJ. Vamos a escuchar de María de Reves de Vamos por Puerto Rico y 32PJ.
Hola, good morning, buenos días. My name is María Reves and I am the Florida State Director for Vamos por Puerto Rico Action, which is a 32BJ initiative, like you said, Natalia. It is an honor to join this conference, this press event this morning, and to have this conversation regarding the importance of deadlines for voter registration, especially on the Latinx and Puerto Rican vote. Let me share a brief description of Vamos por Puerto Rico Action. VAMOS come from the labor movement, and it is thanks to organizations like Service Employee International Union and our parent organization, 32BJ, that we launched this group back in 2016. Today, VAMOS for Puerto Rico is a network of stateside organizations committed to fight for a fair economy for Puerto Ricans on the island and in the states. But you cannot have a thriving and fair economy when people's lives are at risk, and you cannot expect fairness from an electoral system if its citizens are unable to exercise their right to vote. The coronavirus pandemic has many people rightly worried about going out to vote in primary elections, but we can't let the situation silence our voices. If anything, this crisis magnifies the need for accountable leadership that is responsible for the needs of our communities. And today I want to encourage you to participate in the political process and stay safe and healthy. And we can do both. Since around March, when VAMOS for Puerto Rico leadership identified that the impact of COVID-19 was going to have a significant impact on the 2020 elections, we launched our transition program, inviting Puerto Ricans in the island and in the diaspora to educate ourselves about the voting options, including vote by mail and early voting. And we have engaged constantly in panels with experts, but also with other organizations, as well as a call to community members, a relational calls to make that our community, especially in Orange and Osceola, where we know that there are voting precincts that are as much as 99% Puerto Ricans, but also we are also getting in contact with growing Puerto Rican enclaves since Jacksonville to Homestead, and making sure that they're registering to vote by mail. We're so thrilled about the race on vote by mail registration on the communities that we are working, but we also committed to double down efforts on getting those votes out so that Puerto Ricans and Latinx communities and Central Florida are a powerful voting bloc, just like we are now the heart and soul of this vibrant community. So Boricua, you have until Monday, July 20, to register to vote or to update your voter registration. And there are crucial races that we should wait in, races that are more important like ever, like sheriff races and school board, among others. It is our community. Latinos are the most important vote in Florida, and we can steer our communities in our country in the direction that truly reflects the values of working families and our neighbors. And I'm just going to say it in Spanish also. Buenos días, mi nombre es María Rebelles y soy la directora de la Florida de Vamos por Puerto Rico, que es una iniciativa de la Unión 32BJ. Es un honor para mí unirme a esta conversación de prensa y tener esta conversación que es tan importante acerca de las fechas límites para registrarnos para votar, especialmente son importantes para la comunidad Latinx y para el voto puertorriqueño. Me gustaría describir una breve descripción de lo que es Vamos por Puerto Rico. Vamos por Puerto Rico es una iniciativa que viene del movimiento sindical, del movimiento obrero, y es gracias a organizaciones como Service Employee International Union, que es el sindicato de trabajadores de servicio, y nuestro sindicato padre, que es la 32BJ, que nosotros empezamos con este grupo de trabajo allá desde el 2016. En el día de hoy, Vamos por Puerto Rico es una coalición de organizaciones a través del Estado y a través de la Nación, que tenemos un compromiso de pelear por una economía justa para los puertorriqueños en la isla y en los Estados Unidos y para nuestras comunidades en donde vivimos. Pero tú no puedes tener una comunidad justa y una economía que es justa para todos cuando las vidas de las personas están en riesgo. Y tampoco podemos esperar justicia de un sistema electoral si nuestros ciudadanos no pueden ejercer su derecho al voto. La pandemia del coronavirus, del COVID-19, y tiene mucha gente realmente preocupada acerca de cómo votar en las elecciones primarias, que es para las que tenemos que registrarnos antes del 20 de julio, pero nosotros no podemos permitir que esta situación silencie nuestras voces. Si algo, esta crisis tiene que magnificar la necesidad que nosotros tenemos de liderato que se mantenga contable y que responda fielmente a las necesidades de nuestras comunidades. En el día de hoy quiero exhortar a todos los que nos están escuchando a participar en el proceso político, a la misma vez de estar seguro y saludable, porque hay maneras de hacer ambos. Desde marzo, cuando el liderato de Vamos por Puerto Rico empezamos a identificar el impacto del COVID-19 y de las repercusiones que esto podía tener en las elecciones del 2020, nosotros hicimos un lanzamiento de nuestro programa de transición donde empezamos a invitar puertorriqueños en la isla y en la diáspora a educarnos acerca de las opciones para votar, incluyendo el voto por correo y el voto temprano. Y nosotros nos hemos mantenido constantemente, no solamente en paneles con expertos y con otras organizaciones, sino también haciendo bancos de llamada y comunicándonos directo en nuestra comunidad, especialmente en el condado de Orange y Osceola, donde sabemos que van a haber precintos de votar que son tan altos como un 99% puertorriqueños, pero también en nuevos grupos que están creciendo, comunidades latinas y puertorriqueñas, desde Jacksonville hasta Homestead. Asegurarnos que estos puertorriqueños que son recientemente desplazados voten por correo, se registren para votar, conozcan sus derechos aquí en el estado de la Florida, y las comunidades que estamos trabajando, estamos viendo unos resultados increíbles sobre todo en Orange y Osceola, donde el número de registros para votar por el correo se ha disparado en las semanas donde nosotros hemos redoblado nuestros esfuerzos. So, nosotros definitivamente estamos viendo que la comunidad latina está preparada y la comunidad puertorriqueña está preparada para tomar estas elecciones en sus propias manos. Así que, Boricua, tienes hasta el lunes 20 de julio para registrarte o para cambiar tu registración por correo. Hay carreras muy importantes que nosotros tenemos que tomar control de ellas. Hay carreras muy importantes que nosotros queremos participar, como estas carreras de sheriff, como estas carreras de las juntas escolares, donde toman las decisiones que son diarias acerca de nuestra comunidad. Los latinos vamos a ser el voto más importante en la Florida, y definitivamente nosotros podemos dirigir no solo nuestras comunidades, pero también nuestro país en una dirección que realmente refleje los valores de las familias trabajadoras y de nuestros vecinos.
Muchas gracias, María. Thank you so much. So we have our last speaker, Eva Nolasco, but before we go with Eva, I wanted to remind reporters that we have an area for Q&A if you want to ask questions, or you can raise your hands there and say that you want to speak, and I can give you access to the microphone. Ahora vamos a tener a nuestra panelista final, Eva. Pero quiero recordarles a los periodistas que pueden hacer preguntas a través del Q&A chat, o pueden decirme que quieren hacer una pregunta en vivo y yo les puedo dar acceso al micrófono. So Eva is a member of 1189 SCIU4, that is a healthcare worker, that's the union that represents half a million healthcare workers throughout the country. They work at our hospitals right now, they work at nursing homes right now, and they are essential workers that are in the front line of what's happening with COVID. And as a Latina, Eva is here to talk about how they are mobilizing their community members and their coworkers to register to vote and go out and vote. Eva, bienvenida.
Hi, good morning. My name is Eva Nolasco, and I'm a member and delegate and Latino Caucus senior lead for 1189 Florida. But most important, I am a Latino voter. Buenos días, mi nombre es Eva Nolasco, soy miembro y delegado y grupo latino principal de la 1189 SEIU de la Florida, pero lo más importante es que soy votante latina. As a frontline healthcare worker and Latino, now more than ever is the time to get registered to vote. If you are already registered, I encourage those you know who are not to get registered to vote. For the first time, Latinos are expected to be the nation's largest minority to be eligible to vote in a U.S. president election. Monday, July 20 is the deadline to register to vote for the primary election. So I encourage you to register to vote and make your voice heard. Together, we can make a change. We want that one that we want and we need, and deserve because of everything that's going on. You know, as essential workers, we really need to be out there and get registered and go out to vote. Not just get registered, but go out to vote and send those ballots in. Mi nombre, sorry.
Como le decía,
lo más importante es que soy votante latina. Como trabajadores de la salud de primera línea y latina, ahora más que nunca es el momento de ser inscrito para votar. Si ya te registraste, comunícate con tus amistades, tus trabajadores, tus familiares, con toda la gente que conozcas, para que se registren a votar y que también vayan y lleven la boleta cuando sea el día de las primarias. Porque por primera vez se espera que los latinos sean la mayoría minoritaria étnica de la nación que puede inscribirse para votar en una elección presidencial de los Estados Unidos. Lunes 20 de julio es el plazo para inscribirte en las elecciones primarias. Escríbete a votar. Haz que tu voz se oiga. Juntos podemos hacer el cambio que queremos, necesitamos y merecemos como latinos, como trabajadores esenciales y como la minoría que lo miran aquí en los Estados Unidos. So, hagamos nuestras voces escuchar y salgamos a registraros a votar y a votar, que es lo más importante. Y muchas gracias.
Muchas gracias, Eva. Thank you so much, Eva. So last call, I think we're done with our panelist presentations and we are open to receive any questions from community partners or from the media. You can send your questions through the Q&A chat at the bottom of your screen. Estamos abiertos, vamos a hacer 5 minutos más de preguntas para nuestros miembros de la comunidad o para reporteros en los medios. Pueden hacer clic en el Q&A chat que está abajo de sus pantallas. We're going to give 2 more minutes. I don't see any questions yet. Okay, bueno. So there's no questions at the moment. I want to thank all the panelists for sharing your stories. And the work that you're doing to really get out our community to register to vote and to vote both in August and in November. I think it's really important to remind Latinos to vote in the primaries as well, where our lives are not just shaped by the president, but they're also shaped by every single elected official around us, you know, from school boards to mayors, to sheriffs, to state attorneys, especially with the current situation of systemic racism in so many institutions. With the response to COVID, I think we've seen very clearly the role that many of these elected officials have in our lives, from whether deciding to open the school for our kids, or whether holding accountable police officers when they are committing, you know, police brutality or abuse, and so on and so forth, from fixing our unemployment system. So there's so many decisions that candidates that are running in August are going to be able to make, and it's important for us to come out and register to vote so we can vote for those candidates that really represent our values and our community. Bueno, pues muchas gracias a todos. Queremos dejar un mensaje final invitando a la gente que realmente se registren a votar antes del lunes. para si quieren participar en las elecciones del 18 de agosto. Las elecciones son supremamente importantes para nuestra comunidad, especialmente para los latinos. No solo el presidente el que toma las decisiones que impactan nuestra comunidad, pero también son todos los oficiales electos en todos los cargos, desde la junta escolar hasta los sheriffs, hasta los abogados, los fiscales estatales, que están tomando decisiones que afectan nuestra vida, y es importante que salgamos a votar por aquellos que representan nuestros intereses. Well, thank you so much, everyone. And this is the end of our call. We're going to be sharing a recording. Thank you.